Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 15 Beta 4 has been out for a little while now, and there's even more new features and changes that are all throughout the OS. And so I wanted to cover all of them that I did not cover in the initial iOS 15 Beta 4 What's New video. And so the first thing has to do with photos. If we go into photos and then you go to your memories, tap on a memory, tap on it again, you can now tap on share. Prior to this, the share button was actually grayed out. So if we tap on it, tap on share again, we can now choose a soundtrack to share along with the memory. So we'll select a soundtrack. And once we do that, maybe we'll just pick this one, select it, hit done. And now we can share it with individuals. We can save the video or even investigate it according to what we have down here. So you have add to shared album and more. So that's something new in beta 4 that Apple talked about, but never enabled. Now, if we go back, now we have a photo of a landmark. If we tap on it, we'll have an eye with a little star indicating that it will use visual lookup and tell us what it is or more information about it. If we tap on this, it's been slightly redesigned. At the top, you can now see it says lookup, and we have an icon indicating that there's visual lookup. Prior to this, it was just more of a generic look. So if we tap on the same photo in beta 3 that I have in my left hand, you'll see that it's changed a little bit. So on the left is beta 3, on the right is beta 4, and we now have that icon. Before, it was just a little bit different icon. And it also changes between different styles of photos. So if we go to maybe the next photo here, it's actually a flower, and you'll see it's also different as well. So now it recognizes that it's nature and that it's a flower. I can tap on this right here, and you've got the little leaf, and it tells us what it is or finds similar images to it. So it's just a slight refresh of visual lookup overall. And it's not working for everyone. Some people have said that it's still not showing properly with, say, different phones or different things recognizing that it's visual lookup capable yet. So it may be coming in the future if you're not seeing it yet. Now there's a new option within shortcuts. If we go over to shortcuts, and let me find shortcuts here, under home, if I tap on these three dots, you'll see there's a new option for return to home screen. You now have the option to return to home screen. You can use this as a variable based on if, or choose from menu, or set the variable yourself. So it's just a new option they've added within shortcuts itself. Now, if we go into maps, there's a new update there as well. So we'll go into maps. And within maps, if you're using transit information, like I am here for New York City, it will now give you the departure frequency. So you can see it says every 4 to 8 minutes. Prior to this, it just wouldn't show that at all. So you'll see it just shows your upcoming departures as opposed to the overall frequency also. So it's just some additional information they've added within maps. So that's pretty nice. Now within focus modes, there's an update as well. So if we go into focus, and then maybe we go into do not disturb, and then tap on an app or apps, you'll see it now says time sensitive. There's now a new icon for that as well. The icon wasn't there before. It says time sensitive notifications, and they've also moved the location of it. So if you go into apps in beta 3, it's just not there. They've moved it inside of apps. So it's a slight update, nothing huge, but it is a little bit different. Also, if we go into maybe focus modes here, tap on the focus modes, and then maybe go into new focus, you'll see that it's not working on beta 3. Let's go into new focus. There we go. And you'll see under custom, it's now a plus on the right with beta 4, and that looks a little bit different. Some of the overall design is outlined where it isn't in beta 3. And then also, instead of having a little magic wand, we now have a plus button next to custom. So that's something that's been updated as well. Now, also to do with focus modes, if we go to the lock screen, the icon for the focus mode can now just be tapped in order to activate it. In beta 3, you had to press and hold it. So if we tap on it, it does nothing in beta 3, but we have to press and hold. Whereas on beta 4, we can just tap the icon to activate it. So it's just a slight change to the UI overall or how you interact with it. Now within weather, many are saying that they're seeing new animations at night. Now it's daytime here, but if we go to, say, Dubai, where it's a little bit later in the day, you can see that there's a starry night now with some clouds moving by. Some people have said they haven't seen this prior to beta 4. So there's some nice new animations. There are many different animations, and I'm sure we'll see more as the betas continue. But you can see the clouds are moving ever so slightly, and it looks really nice. Now, something they've brought back in beta 3 has to do with undo. This is something that I used all the time. So maybe you delete an email and you want to bring that back. You can three-finger swipe to bring it back to undo or redo. So three-finger swipe to redo, three-finger swipe to undo. This was there prior to iOS 15 betas. It was removed, and you had to use the shake to undo feature prior to this. So you had to shake your phone, it would undo, and then you could undo. So that was something I really didn't like. I like the three-finger swipe to redo and undo. So that's been brought back with beta 4. Now, if you go into settings and then maybe search for network, if we search for network and reset network settings, tap on this, it now brings you to the correct place of transfer or reset iPhone. Prior to this, it would not bring you to this place. So if you go into settings, we'll go back here, go back into our settings, again, search for network on beta 3, tap on it, it just brings you into your general settings. Now it's bringing you to the correct place. And something else they've changed here as well is if you tap on erase all content and settings, it brings you to a new screen, of course, and we'll do the same on beta 3. And you can see at the bottom, it used to say erase this iPhone. Now it says continue. So you would tap on erase this iPhone and it pops up and says, are you sure you want to erase? Now when you tap on continue, it asks for your passcode. So you get to this point and it asks for your passcode and then you can proceed. So that's been updated. It's just a slight change and something they've changed to maybe add some more steps so you don't accidentally erase your phone and to help you better prepare for maybe moving to a new phone. Now, when you're using your AirPods with a phone call, they've changed some of the way the icons look as well. So maybe you have an AirPod Pro in your ear. I'll connect it, wait for it to connect here. It'll take just a moment. You'll see I have the AirPods connected or my AirPods Pro and the icon is showing properly in the control center. However, when I place a call, this will now change based on what you're doing. So if I place a phone call, you'll see I'm placing a call. If I go into the control center, it's now the phone icon. Prior to this, it may not show properly. So it's something that's just a little bit different. If we go back in, it switches back to your AirPods. It's a slight update or change. Now, also, if you're using Beats headphones with your iPhone, they've updated the icon size within the code. Prior to this, it was a little bit smaller. At 40 pixels, it's now 68 pixels. So maybe you're connecting your iPhone, the different icons that you're seeing pop up, and it finally showed up on my 12 Pro Max. The icons have been updated and refreshed and also are a larger size when they're connected to your phone in places like the control center. So instead of being 40 pixels as they were before, they're now 68 pixels. So maybe you'll see a larger iPad in the future that we need these higher resolution images from. So that makes a lot of sense if we're going to see something that's a little bit bigger, or maybe they just wanted to update the quality overall. Now, in the prior video, I told you about how they updated the notification icon in your settings. They've also updated it for the Apple Watch. So if we slide up with watchOS 8 beta 4, scroll down, you'll see notification. The icon is slightly different. So it's a little bit different than what we had before. Not a huge change, but something to note. Also, one thing that's not working properly that people are seeing a little bit differently is if you go into your settings, go down to privacy, tap on privacy, then go to location services, scroll all the way down, go to system services, and then scroll down again to significant locations, tap on this, it will take my Face ID, scan, and then crash. Now, if you're able to get into that, it looks a little bit different this time around than it does with beta 3. So I could not get this to open on this phone or another phone I have on beta 4. So if you're seeing that, I'd love to hear from you and see if it works for you. It's not working for me at all. Now, finally, within the wallet app, if you go to add an Apple card, there's a new privacy policy. So they've updated that. Of course, it's very long, so you have to look for the changes, but there are some changes within there. And so that's everything new in iOS 15 beta 4 that I didn't mention in the previous video. Of course, many of those are not huge changes. Some are some nice features and updates with photos and maps, of course. But if you found anything else, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.